Hello everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. So this video, you're going to talk about one topic which is very important, and you're going to be needing this way forward. The question is posted onto you. Check the screen. What is the question? What is REST API? So this whole tutorial is going to be based on this. How to create REST API. What actually is REST API? What can this REST API help us? That is what we're going to talk about in the whole tutorial. So this is very interesting, and by the end of the whole tutorial videos, you're going to understand what a REST API is, and you're going to also create it yourself so you can create for others as well, right? It's going to be interesting. So first of all, let's talk about what is a REST API. Now, you know, for every video, I'm trying to make it short, so it's going to be interesting for you. Okay, so it's going to be short and short videos. Let's move on. So first of all, what is REST API? Let me chip one in first. I have a small note that we're going to be reading from. So you can also read, can just put something down from the note too as well. Isn't good? I know and I believe it is. So let's see. This side is giving us a real and actually sensible definition. So when you say a REST API, what does it mean? So a REST API, also known as RESTful API. So as soon as you hear REST, it's the same as RESTful API. So this is an application programming interface. That is an API. So API stands for application programming interface that conforms to constraint of REST architectural style and allows for interaction with RESTful web services. So REST stands for representational state transfer and was created by computer scientist Roy. Okay, so what you want to actually get here is REST API. It is an application programming interface that allows user to interact with their web services. We know what it stands for: representational state transfer. Alright, I have this actually is giving us a more insight on the API. So when we talk about API, what is API? So let's see, it is sometimes refers to as a contract between an informal provider and an information user. So this is information provider and the user. So simply you can talk of what, a client and a server. This is the provider and this is the user. So this API, it interacts between them. I learned this in an example here. So let's see. In other words, if you want to interact with a computer or a system to retrieve information or perform a function, an API helps you communicate what you want the system or that system to do, so you can understand and fulfill their request. You can think of an API as a mediator between the users or client and the resources of or web service they want to get. So now you see, when you go to a restaurant, you see we have the waiter. Now the waiter comes to you and asks you, what do you want to eat? You just choose it, the waiter gets in and returns you the food, right? The chef is in there, they prepare, they give it to the waiter, they bring it to you. So the waiter here, it is an API. Now this RESTful is an architectural way. Let's get back to my small notes here. So now you see that the REST, you know what it stands for? Representational state transfer. This is the pattern that is followed to create an API. So a pattern, a steps, a procedure to follow to create an API. We can talk of what? REST. Now you know REST API stands for application programming interface. So REST API allow application to interact with each other and exchange data. So that is the core duty of what? REST API. Now these are the constraints of REST API. So if you want to create REST API, you must follow these protocols. So client server constraints. So the client request, server provides. As you know, you request, server provides. Browser is the client and API is the server. So to a layman, API is going to provide to you. So API are going to tell us a server. But in the tactical way, the API, it is a middleman. Gets to the server, grabs it, and then provide to the user. Two, it must be stateless constraint. The communication between client and the server must be stateless, meaning nothing should be stored on the server related to the client. So the client information shouldn't be stored on the server. What initiates it? When a client sends a request, everything that the server needs to get to process it and return to the client, it is bulk or it is included in the request. So here, no information is being stored in the server's memory. Now, cacheable constraints. So servers should let the client know the duration for that stored data in the cache. So the client won't request until cache what? Expires. Now, you know cache as stored. So when data is being sent to you, when data has been processed by the server and sent a copy to the client, you can cache it to the web service memory. So the web service memory, the cache data there has a duration to expire. So when the duration expires, it means the client can't have access to. So you must alert the client the duration. As soon as it expires, the client get back to you and get a new data. And it should have a uniform interface. So this defines the interface between the client and the server. So these four constraints, REST API must follow this. Then what are the things that you're supposed to consider? In creating REST API, there are two things involved. You have a resource and you have HTTP verbs. Resource includes your product, employees, customers, others, and etc. Okay. Now the HTTP verbs here consist of the get, so these are the HTTP methods. So get, post, put or patch, and we have delete. So in the video, we're going to talk about these guys here, so don't worry. So if you actually can have understanding to this, then we can talk of, let's say you have HTTP, that's a protocol. So the netcodehub.com is a domain name. So API here is going to be the optional, and this, that's going to be the resources, going to be the endpoint. So after creating the API, we must have protocol, domain name, API or optional, then you're going to have the endpoint. Now there's a tool that's going to help us a lot in it, but I'm going to use it for this video. But you can actually download it, maybe later talk about that. That is a Postman. So it is used to check an API, how to issue a request, and other stuff as well. All right, so our next video, we talk about what? Starting to create an API. So how do you create a REST API? We talk about that in the next video. And that video is going to be pieces, okay? Short. We're not going to spend much time on each video. So it's going to be short so you can actually follow, learn, and practice it as well. So for now, you must understand what a RESTful API is, what actually API is, and what is a RESTful API, and how is API important in our web design. You know, API stands or serves as intermediate or the mediator between a server and a client. So the server, the client requests from the mediator gets it from the server. The mediator here, that is the API. So API can term as also a server to a client as well. All right, so thank you guys for watching. I believe this is clear. This explanation is clear. If it is not, you can actually read more on the internet. But actually, this is giving you the summary knowledge on that I need to actually have so we can actually move on. Let's give you a break. When we return, we start with the development of the API.